Now, turning our attention now to player movements. Gentlemen, we are seeing that, you know, you look at this move of Alex Song, Greg Itafia, really playing at the highest level. You know, sometimes I wanted to wonder, Djibouti. I'm like, this country is on the African continent, lowly ranked.
185.
Yeah, and 185.
Yeah, 185.
In the world.
In the world.
In Africa, I think it's 51st, somewhere there. And now, Alex Song, former Cameroonian international, coming to play for one of the sides there in Djibouti. You could have come to South Africa. You could have gone to North Africa. You could have gone even to the Middle East.
Yeah. But I think there's something special about this movement. I think maybe there's going to be a relationship with the president, which I think for him to move to that side. But nevertheless, they're playing the CAF Confederations Cup. You know, and I think it's one of the motivation too. But you know, we know Alex for right from time. You know, with the virus that you know we have now. You know, remember they told him to you know he has to forfeit some of his money in Swiss there, and he decided not to do that, and he got sacked. So there's gonna be money involved for him to move this big movement. He once said it when he moved to Barcelona that I'm ready to stay on the bench. As far as I'm getting the million, you know, and taking care of
so
the family.
It's
about the money.
What kind of money is he going to get from Djibouti?
More than the Middle East.
Money
because
money
he has a relationship. He has a relationship with the president, and after that, he's gonna have some youth. He's gonna do some youth coaching there. I think he's going. It's more deep than what we're seeing now because he signed a 1-year contract and 1-year option. So I think there's a lot. It's more than soccer. I think there's a lot of things, and with a big name like him. What more do you expect? I mean, go there, you need to lift the country up.
Okay, another move as well, Timothy, that might happen, might go on the cards. FC Pyramids, we all know about them, this Egyptian Premier League side, you know, really, bags full of money, trying to make sure that, yeah, they compete with the likes of Al Ahly and Zamalek. Now, we're told that they might be after Mario Balotelli.
Why me? Mario Balotelli, I think... that's not, I believe that's no. That's a rumor that has been, you know, passed around. Mario Balotelli just lost his contract in the Serie A. We know who Mario is. At this moment in time, he's training with a Serie D team just to keep fit. And I think Pyramid has come out to say, no, those rumors are not true. But also we have information that West Ham may be interested in signing him or Watford. So that augurs well for this young man who 8 years back you could think that he would be the next big thing, you know, in European football. But he has been his own enemy. The talent is not in question. It's just his focus. However, I think Pyramid has got some good marriage out of this advert of trying to get Mario Balotelli into the Egyptian league. If he does sign for Pyramids, it means that he'll be joining Maruda, who play in the Egyptian Premier League after donning the you know playing in the English Premier League. But if you have got a player of Mario Balotelli winning the Champions League, Premier League champion, and then coming down to the African continent, I think we shall have a good brand to talk about.
Because probably they have a new coach from Argentina too, you know, Rudolph. I think,
yeah,
I mean,
he has been attracting players from Brazil.
Yeah, they don't have the money.
Yes,
yeah.
They do have the money.
Yeah, they have the money without fans.
But
the problem with the Balotelli. Balotelli is going to beat all the referees on the continent when they will be playing CAF competition. Because you won't take any nonsense as a referee. He will be banned today, banned tomorrow. But he's, you know, his credentials speak for themselves.
Yeah,
because I remember in 2012, he's the one who took Italy to the final of the Euro 2012.
Yeah.
So he's a very, very excellent player. But the problem is he's, you know.
Even winning the Premier League with Manchester City.
City,
there's no doubt that he's a talent.
You can't doubt his talent.
You know, under Mourinho in Inter Milan. For me, the fact that we can be speaking about Mario Balotelli coming on the African continent, that in itself, what does it say to our African continent as a brand of football? I think if we get the right leadership, if we get to brand our football better, I think we can become a better football nation.
Talk of Djibouti and Song.
I think if you look at how it is recommended to retire when you come from the top league, you need to go down to wind down your career. But for me, I would love to applaud Song for the fact that he has chosen to retire on the African continent. You can imagine those young kids who are going to train with him or participate with him. I think the vision of this leader, Timoro, the owner of this club, I think needs to be applauded. We need to get more owners of clubs getting our brothers who have played in Africa and in Europe to come back, home. But again, CAF as administrator, we need to improve our infrastructure. We should be able to retire back home in our respective countries to give back our talent back to our own people.
Definitely, I'm sure there's more that our players that have plied their trade in Europe, when they come back home, there's a lot that they can offer. Talking about as well player movement, there's one locally here in South Africa that has happened. Jeff, his name is Mark Makusu Mundele. Yes, Mundele joining Orlando Pirates on a loan from AS Vita. Tell us more about the strike and how the move came about.
Oh, he's a very good player. You know, he's he was over the campaign that won the CHAN in 2016, even the CHAN which was in South Africa in 2014. He was also part of the of that team, though I don't support CHAN anyway. So, but
produced him a player.
No, CHAN didn't produce him. CHAN didn't produce him.
Give him a platform.
But he's a prolific striker. Yeah. You know, so in 2018, he was the second best scorer in Africa in that competition. Yeah. Yes, and they played in the final against Raja Casablanca, and they lost. He's a very good. He will strengthen because we talked about this with the current Zambian coach.
Mitchell
wanted him. Mitchell wanted him.
Whilst he was still at Pirates.
Yes, once he was still at Pirates. Okay. Yeah, and after that it was. And I did speak to Florent Ibenge that look they want Mundele. And
Serious
he says
player
that,
agent.
And then and then he says no, the general won't release him. He's very precious to the general, and I'm sure that he's been sold just because the general Tango Four, Gabriel Amisi, is no more part of the. He lost elections, so he's been replaced by a lady called Bestine Kazadi. Mm-hmm. So she's the one who facilitated this loan. But in the mind of Vita, he's a player who has to go to Europe for them, unless things can change. When he's still at Pirates. But with Mitchell, when we closed that chapter, we opened another chapter of Ricky Tulenge, who used to play for DSMP. Orlando Pirates wanted him too, but by that time it was not possible. But now, Vita, since the new season started, they bought Ricky Tulenge from DSMP Motema Pembe. So, which means that there's now a space to release one of the prolific strikers. And they chose that's how it came about, actually.
Good move for Pirates. Look, you've seen them play.
Yeah.
Now, here's another story. They've been on red hot form, doing so well so far. Now they are bringing this striker. The intention is clear.
I think Pirates, you know, this season, they just want to win the league. You know, they want to win not the league alone. There's a lot of teams, you know. And it's time for them, you know, at least the past 5 years. They haven't done anything. So they need to replace the supporter. But I think, I mean, with the league in Congo, I think he played 3 games, score 1 goal, assist 1 for now before he came on loan. I'm prepared to take someone on loan. It must be a special player, you know. And before he got injured, you know, he has been scoring a lot of goals, you know, over 40-something, 48 goals,
and
you know.
Papa should be lucky because last year he was injured.
Yeah.
While he has also pre-signed for Renaissance Bekan.
But
he's a player that team also, no stranger to, we have played in Europe as well.
Yes,
so he comes with loads and loads of experience. Leading that up front, and they'll be hoping that he'll bang in the goals.
And we very well know that Orlando Pirates is going to be playing in the Champions League, in the CAF Champions League. So he comes in handy, you know, to lead this young squad, especially the front line, because if you don't score goals, you don't win games. And so I think they've got the right mix, the right choice of a candidate in Mark. It's unprecedented Orlando Pirates signing a player on a season-long loan. So the intention, yes, the intentions are very clear. Yeah. They know where they are heading, and I think it will be kept for a long time.
And it will be a very good.
It will be very interesting that Pirates has qualified for the finals against Brentford and Celtic.
Yeah.
And now they have this prolific striker. He doesn't normally miss. He's very good.
Yeah, but his style of player, he doesn't play like an African player, groomed in Africa.
Yeah.
And it will be very pleasurable for Zimbabwe, because he will see the way he touched the ball. He gives an option. You give him the ball. He's a very good, and especially for Pirates, as they will be competing in the Confederation Cup, it is a very good boost.
And the other good thing, what Pirates did, I liked what they did, because they start from the back. You see the euphoria, the captain for Bafana Bafana.
They're beefing up.
They stabilize the back, and, they won aggregate 5-0 against Chiefs. That says something big. Now, they have scored 5 goals, and with this striker coming in, they'll be giving people 8 or 9 or 10.
Buccaneers, you are in for a good time. You welcome Marcus Mundele. Hopefully, yes, we score a goal for
Iron Duke.
Yes.
He's selling he likes Congolese players too much.
Yeah. I was about to say that.
Jeto Kambale, Jeto
Kambale,
Etienne Sundale, Lombele,
the man with the single glove,
Kalamba, Kazadi, so all of them. He likes Congolese players.
A whole lot of players coming from the DR Congo there who have done well for the black and white jersey. They'll be hoping that the same will be for Jean-Marc Mundele. We wish him everything of the best in his new club, of course, on loan from AS Vita.